Hello everybody, this is Karthik, welcome to Kachu Travels, and today we'll be going to Ettina Bhuja. It's a small peak that's on the Sakleshpura Chikmagalur part of Karnataka, and it's on the Bangalore-Mangalore highway, a slight detour but on the Bangalore-Mangalore highway. And right now we've just crossed the Nelamangala bypass and we're on our way through Chandrayapatna and Hassan. And joining me on this trip is my friend Vinay. Vinay, say hi. Very unusual because this is summer season and you don't see so much of fog, but it's good to see these weather patterns. So after breakfast, we ended up reaching Sakleshpur in about 3 hours, and we settled into a hotel called Durga International. And one of the reasons was we wanted a place which had access to telephone signals, guaranteed 4G and Wi-Fi if possible. So we've settled in here. Our trek anyway starts tomorrow morning, so we thought it'll be good to sleep well the previous night and then wake up and follow the trek instructors from here. So we're following a team called Adventure Buddha, and they're going to come here much later in the night, or rather early next morning at about 3 o'clock, and we just tailgate them all the way up till a temple which is where we park our car.
Let me show you how our room looks.
So we spent the day working, and for the evening we decided to ask the hotel staff, and they told us a place to go to which was a railway bridge a little beyond Sakleshpura railway station to go spend the evening. This railway bridge is half a kilometer from Sakleshpura railway station towards Bangalore. The bridge has space for people to walk on, but it's not advisable to stay on that bridge when a train is passing by. But other than that, it provides great views of a sunset on either sides. Sakleshpura actually has a thing with these railway tracks. In the other direction, Sakleshpura to Donegal, it is called the Green Route. It's a very famous railway track back in the days when trains weren't running on the stretch. It is also said to be a dangerous trek at that point, and as a result was banned subsequently. But we weren't doing any of that. We were just here to spend time in the evening by the Hemavati River. The riverbed is actually quite marshy, so there aren't enough spots to actually go sit there. We spent about an hour and then decided it was time to get home.
YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, and of course my own blog www.kachutravels.com.